Quran chapter 11, verse 46, lesson 1418. Title is Reality's Condition, Surah Huud. Peace be upon him. I seek refuge in God from Satan the outcast. In the name of God, the Beneficent, the Merciful. Verse 46, he said, O Nuh, peace be upon him, lo, he is not of the household. Lo, he is of evil conduct. So ask not of me that whereof thou hast no knowledge. I admonish thee, lest thou be among the ignorant. Commentary. Amala, work. Whatsoever a man practices is his work, conduct. Here it aims at conduct, that is to say, your son is evildoer. Ma laysa laka bihii ilm, that whereof thou hast no knowledge, i.e., you should not ask for such thing about which you don't know, that whether it is suitable or otherwise. For example, deliverance of Canaan, son of Noah, peace be upon him. It is commanded that desires should be in obedience to the commandment of Allah Almighty. It is called patience, resignation, and endurance. In addition to above, this boy, son of Noah, peace be upon him, was not included in your household, because only such person can be of household whose conduct is according to the conduct of other members of the household. That person may be a member of good person's household who is good himself. Yam was of evil conduct, a malefactor. Living in a house or place in the world is not sufficient for being a member of the household, although apparent behavior with him is the same as with other members of the household. In the hereafter, only he is the member of the household who is a partner in belief and good works along with his elders. Otherwise, after death, any believer will not have any relationship, any connection with any infidel. Only pious, abstinent, and good God-fearing people will be relatives and companions of one another. After that, it is commanded, you are being admonished and causing to hear for the purpose that lest you be not among the ignorant people. In fact, your son Yam and his mother are not members of your household. They did not adopt your religion, but liked to live astray along with other straying people. You don't know that they will never adopt the way of goodness, but we, that is Allah Almighty, know that they cannot come unto the straight path, so you should not recommend them. Urdu mein samaat farmaiye, unwan hai haqeeqat e haal. A'udhu billahi minash-Shay-taanir. Bis-Millaahir-Rah-maanir-Rahiim. Qaala yaa-Nuuhu Innahuu laysa min ahlik. Innahuu amalun gayru saalih. Falaa alni ma laysa laka bihii. Inniii izuka takuuna minal-jaa-hiliin. Farmaya, ay Nuh, wo tere ghar walon mein se nahi, uske kaam kharab hain, so mujhse mat pooch jo tujhko maloom nahi. Main tujhko nasihat karta hoon ki tu jahilon mein se na ho jaye. Amala, kaam, aadmi jo kare wo uska amal kehlata hai. Yahan isse murad amal wala hai, matlab ye ki tera beta bure amal wala hai. maa laysa laka bihi ilm, woh baat jiska tujhe ilm nahi, yani aisi baat mat maang jiske munasib ya namunasib hone ka tujhe ilm nahi. Masalan kanaan ki nijaat, irshad hai ke jazbaat ko Allah ke hukm ke tabe karna chahiye, isi ka naam sabr o tahammul hai. Ilawa bani ye ladka tere ahl mein dakhil hi nahi tha, kyunki ahl woh ho sakta hai jo uski aadaton aur khasooton mein uska mushabih ho. Nek aadmi ka ahl woh hai jo khud nek ho. Ye ladka to buri aadaton wala badkar tha. Duniya ke andar ek jagah ya ek makan mein sukoonat rakhna ahl hone ke liye kaafi nahi, go zahiri bartao uske saath hui ho jo ahl ke saath hota hai. Aakhirat mein ahl woh hai jo apne badon ke saath imaan aur nek kaamon mein shareek ho, warna marne ke baad momin aur kafir ka koi taluq aur rishta baki nahi rahega. Sirf muttaqi aur parhezgar ek dusre ke saathi aur rishtedar honge. Aage irshad hai ki ye baatein nasihat ki tujhe is gharz ke liye sunai ja rahi hain ke tera shumar jahilon mein na ho jaye. Tera ye ladka aur uski maa haqeeqat mein tere ahl ke andar dakhil nahi hain. Unhone tera tareeqa ikhtiyar nahi kiya balki gumrahon ke saath gumrah rehna pasand kiya. Tujhe ye maloom nahi ke ye durust na honge, lekin hame maloom hai ke ye raah raast par nahi aa sakte, isliye unki sifarish na kar. Sadaqa Allahu Mawlana al-Azim wa sadaqa Rasuluhu Nabiyul Ummiyul Kareem.